1.5 trillion pesos, 40% of the proposed 2019 budget of 3.7 trillion pesos. That is what Batangas governor says is owed to local government units after the Supreme Court ruled the national government had been wrongfully withholding LGU's share in customs collections.
That still has accumulated because that was since 1992. That's the time when the local government code of 91 was implemented, 1992. So, 26 years ago. So, accumulated yung utang, yung hindi na pupay, amounts to approximately 1.5 trillion.
Last week, the Supreme Court announced it had ruled in favor of Mandana's six-year-old petition, saying LGUs are entitled to a share in all national taxes, currently being used as basis for LGUs' internal revenue allocation, or IRA. Economic managers are resisting the ruling. Budget Secretary Ben Jokno says allocating more revenues to LGUs could bloat the budget deficit to 6% of GDP, about double 2019's target of 3.2%. Finance Undersecretary Carl Chua says this could also affect confidence in the Philippines.
That's going to be very
to the ratio
big.
Of GDP.
Currently, we are targeting 3%. Anything above that, especially if it gets closer to 4% or higher, is going to be causing some uncertainty. So definitely, that's a risk that we have to manage if the decision becomes final.
Mandana says this is not true.
Divide it into 10 years, halimbawa lang. So, yung 1.5 trillion amounts to only 150 billion. Kung isipin mo ang budget ng Pilipinas, eh, by next year, ngayon 3.75. Yung 150 billion, hindi na ganun kalaki.
Mandanas adds he and his fellow LGU leaders are not asking for a bigger budget. They are asking for a larger share in the existing budget. He suggests funding the additional cash for LGUs by allowing LGUs to take over the services provided by national government.
Ang i-devolve mo lang yung kaya nilang gawin. Halimbawa, pamimili o anong klaseng fertilizer, mas nakakaalam yung town, yung municipality, kesa sa nandito sa Imperial Manila. Yung sasakit, bumili lang din vaccine para sa lahat. Hindi naman nila pa. Tapos ngayon, nung magkaroon ng problema, ang sisisihin local government. Ano ba yung iras ang bagaling? Galing yon sa VAT, galing yon sa income tax, galing yon sa mga excise tax. Huwag natin kalilimutan, sino ba nagbabayad nun? Hindi ba mga taga-barangay din? Mga taga-cities and municipalities din? Hindi naman nakatira dun sa Metro Manila, sa Centro Manila ng mga pinagkukunan ng income tax.
Mandanas called his proposal the start of true federalism. For the DOF, it's crucial the money is managed properly.
So the uncertainty would be coming from the risk that we are not on top of our fiscal house. That's why it is something that we have to clearly manage. That's why we have to do tax reform. That's why we have to do budget reforms so that we keep the fiscal house in order. Because that's the biggest source of credibility for this for the economic program.
On Monday, the Cabinet approved the proposed 3.7 trillion peso budget for 2019, including an allocation of 641 billion pesos for LGUs. Mandanas has already written Jokno to increase the 2019 IRA for LGUs by 200 billion pesos before it is presented to lawmakers for approval. Warren de Guzman, ABS-CBN News.